Price drop alert on aisle five, it's happening all over the interwebs. Onward and upward, how we doing everyone? Diving into Skechers running shoes 2020 here in the studio. But the reason I'm making this video today is because last week I made a new playlist all about ASICS running shoes, and sure enough, a lot of people appreciated me putting all of the ASICS running shoes that I've tested out in 2020 into one video so they can compare, because I get it. It's hard sometimes to go back into the archive and watch, you know, 3, 4, 5 videos. You just don't have that kind of time. So today, we are gonna focus in just on Skechers. I'm gonna give you my thoughts, my comparisons. We'll get into some drops, some price drops. It's getting crazy out there. But I do wanna mention that the Skechers Razor 3 was one of my first Skechers shoes that I ever wore as far as a running shoe goes. So here's the deal. I don't know about you, but when I think of Skechers, I'm still stuck in high school, I guess. Like, Skechers to me, back in the day, now I'm, you know, 2004 was a long time ago, but Skechers was not a running shoe company. So I'm still a little bit, it's still hard mentally for me to get excited about Skechers running shoes, but I do believe they are actually making progress and innovation and bringing more competition to the running shoe marketplace, which hopefully will keep other running shoe companies in check with respect to prices, all right? Because we're, you know, we're buying shoes, it costs money, we got to save our, you know, we got to pinch our pennies, and Skechers thankfully is one of those companies out there that keeps their prices at a pretty good level. It could be better, but at a pretty good level. Now, just like last week when I made a new playlist just for ASICS running shoes, I did this last night as well. I had never done it before because we've got Nike, we've got Salomon, we've got, I believe we have a Hoka playlist, an ASICS playlist, and now finally a Skechers running shoe playlist. So upper right hand corner, if you want to take a deeper dive into these running shoes that we're going to be going over today, the Skechers Go Run Ride 8, the Skechers Horizon Vanish, the Skechers Speed Elite Hyper, the Skechers Go Meb Speed 6, and the Skechers Go Run Speed Trail. But I will give a shout out, I must say, to one of my favorite 2019 running shoes, the Skechers Max Road 4, a maximalist road running shoe that I actually did a lot of long runs in this shoe. They treated me well. Definitely very neutral though, keep that in mind. In fact, I'll just say most of Skechers running shoe lineup is a very neutral focused. For example, the Horizon Vanish, one of the most neutral road running shoes I've ever tried. Now, before we dive in, remember the running shoe rotation vlog where I talk about pairing your running shoes with the types of runs that you are doing. So a long run shoe, a tempo day shoe, an easy day shoe. So I just wanna remind you of that vlog, and it's gonna connect to all of these Skechers shoes that we are breaking down today. Okay, let's dive in. An easy day shoe, the Skechers Go Run Ride 8. We're looking at a 6 millimeter drop, 30 millimeter stack height in the heel, 24 millimeter in the forefoot, coming in at 8.7 ounces in men's size 9, all right? And here's what's crazy, $115 brand new, but now it's $80 on Running Warehouse. Again, prices are dropping because of everything that's happening out there in the economy. Like, if you have a little money saved up and you want to build out your running shoe rotation for the summertime coming up, now is the time to buy, because again, prices have been cut. I've seen anywhere from 25% all the way up to 40%, and even a couple places I've seen 50%. So anyway, Go Run Ride 8 Skechers, a go-to easy day shoe for me. Love nothing, no bells and whistles on this shoe. A very simple shoe, but it gets the job done for easy days. Again, the Skechers Go Run Ride 8. And the reason I'm not holding it up for you right now is because Michael is taking a nap and the Go Run Ride 8 is in his room, and you don't wake up a sleeping baby. You all know that. Okay, moving on to the Tempo Day shoe. Oh man, butter my bread. The Skechers Horizon Vanish. There it is, a 4 millimeter drop, 20 millimeter stack height in the heel, 16 millimeter in the forefoot. We're looking at 5 ounces. 5 ounces in men's size 9, 4.6 ounces in my size. 4.6 ounces, absolutely unbelievable. Brand new was at $100. Now we're looking at $80 for the Skechers Horizon Vanish, and this is a bestseller. I've seen it's like going off the shelves. A lot of people are picking up the shoe. And of course, the reason I love the Horizon Vanish is the weight. You just can't beat it. And there's enough, and there's still enough stack height in that heel and the forefoot, but especially the heel, where you don't feel like the pavement is beating up your legs too much. So Horizon Vanish Tempo Day shoe, absolutely love it. Okay, moving on to the Skechers GoMeb Speed 6, all right? So we're looking at 4 millimeter drop, 24 millimeter stack height in the heel, 20 in the forefoot, 5.7 ounces in men's size 9, was $135, now coming in at $95. So dips under that $100 mark. This is a race day shoe. I'm gonna put this into the 5K and 10K category, all right? Could you take it to a half marathon? You could, but I actually, the next shoe is gonna be my half marathon shoe. I am really enjoying this shoe, but I must say, I don't think I would take it past, let's say, if you're looking for a shoe that can go past 10 miles, I don't think this is the shoe for you. I will also mention real quick, as far as the uppers go on all of these shoes, it's that same translucent upper material that Skechers is known for, incredibly lightweight. And so in the innovation department, with respect to keeping the weight down on their Skechers lineup, I think they're nailing it with respect to the upper. Now, it's not a... it's not like an incredible lockdown feel, but at the same time, I personally don't feel like I'm gonna jump out of the shoe, okay? There's enough material there that I still feel like the shoe is one with my foot, I think is the best way to describe the feeling that I get in the Skechers lineup with respect to their uppers. One last point on the GoMeb Speed 6 is I did notice that I may need to go a half size up. Kind of surprised me. Like I could fit into the shoe. It felt a little snug though through that toe box. Just putting it out there, keep that in mind. Make sure wherever you pick up, if you pick up this shoe, that they have a good return policy in case you need to send them back and exchange them for a different size. All right, so keep that in mind with this guy. And moving on to that next race day shoe from Skechers, the Speed Elite Hyper, their version of the carbon fiber plate running shoes that are arriving on the marketplace. I'm not sold completely yet that this is gonna be competing with other carbon fiber plate shoes out there, okay? Especially for the marathon distance. In fact, I'll say it right now, I would not race a marathon in this shoe. I don't think there's enough stack height. So 28 millimeter stack height in the heel, 24 in the forefoot for a 4 millimeter drop. I want a little more if I'm gonna go 26 miles. But I will say, half marathon, I would be very excited to race a half marathon in the Speed Elite Hyper. Now, they are keeping the weight down, 5.7 ounces in men's size 9, that's amazing. Price point, $180, brand new. What is the price now after the price drops happening across the interwebs? $180. So for some reason, this shoe has not dropped in price. I'm not exactly sure why. I like it a lot, I must say. I think it could also be a really solid go-to threshold day shoe, or even taking it out on the track for some interval work. But as far as racing a marathon, it is not gonna be my go-to. All right, there you go. And last but not least, in the race day shoe lineup, we're going to the trails, everyone. The Skechers Go Run Speed Trail. Look at all that mud on there, taking it out to the trails. I actually really enjoyed this shoe. However, I haven't been able to race in it yet. So this is a race day shoe for sure. I'm gonna say 10K, maybe half marathon on the trails. Not a ultra marathon type of racing day shoe for the Go Run Speed Trail. 26 millimeter stack height in the heel, 22 in the forefoot, 8.2 ounces in men's size 9, so not nearly as lightweight as their road shoe lineup, but still pretty good for a trail. Actually, still pretty solid for trail shoes, because trail racing shoes are always heavier than road racing shoes, just so you know. And it was $115. coming in at $80 now. So that's a pretty amazing price if you're looking for an affordable trail racing shoe. And as far as the outsole, since it is a trail shoe, I'll mention real quick, the lug depth is not really aggressive, but there's enough there that you can definitely do some decent trails that are fairly aggressive. You know, if you're battling a lot of mud, like a lot of mud, this would not be a good shoe to wear. But I would say a buffed out trail for sure, or a trail that has some decent loose gravel. I just wouldn't race in this shoe in really muddy conditions, okay? So there you go, the Skechers Go Run Speed Trail. But the question becomes now, if I could only purchase one Skechers running shoe from the 2020 lineup thus far, no doubt it would be the Skechers Horizon Vanish. Ladies and gentlemen, just like I said in the full review, I love this shoe. I would also race in this shoe for a 5K. I really would. In fact, I might do that in 2020 once the races get going again. I love this shoe that much. The midsole is just, okay. So the midsole on the Horizon Vanish is more forgiving than the Speed 6 and the Speed Elite Hyper. So if you don't want to beat your legs up too much, I think this midsole will be a little more forgiving for you. And okay, it's very loosey-goosey, but I think especially if you can get up on your toes and strike on your forefoot, I think you're gonna love being in control of the shoe and not letting the shoe be in control of you, all right? That's the feeling I get when I'm out there going fast in the Skechers Horizon Vanish. I may just pick up another pair of the Horizon Vanish sooner rather than later, especially if 5K road races get back up and running. And there you have it. All right, just reviewing the shelf here. I think we covered them all, except for, of course, the Go Run Ride 8s, the Easy Day shoes. They are inside the house. One more time, Skechers running shoes 2020. Oh, thank you, Skechers, for keeping the prices down, especially during these crazy times. And yes, let's do it. Question of the day, what shoes are you buying right now that are on sale, and where are you picking them up, okay? As people, I mean, it's crazy, but people are losing jobs. They're shutting down their businesses, and we all gotta look out for each other, help each other save some money during some just uncertainty that's happening out in the economy. So let's help each other down in the comments. If you have some smoking deals, let us know where they are happening. All right, Skechers 2020, who'd have thunked it? Who'd have thunked it? All right, everyone, thanks for being here. Thanks for watching. I appreciate you taking the time to stop in to the studio. All right, we're gonna throw it back to the ASICS playlist that I created last week. In case you're interested in learning more about the ASICS running shoe lineup, it'll be right there. Love you all. Love you all. All right, everyone, seek beauty, work hard, and love each other. See you tomorrow.